Hello, thank you for joining me on this lovely spring day. I'm at Stoke Park in Guildford amongst the daffodils. But what we've come here to do today is another episode of Miniature Railway Britain and see the Guildford Model Engineering Society's Miniature Railway, which is just over here, as you can see, for anyone who is driving or walking. It's fairly obvious. It says steam train ride, so that's what we've come here to do. So this is their car park. There's my car over there. I have actually driven here. I just walked over there to start the video. You could come by train because Guildford London Road station is only just there. Well, I say just there, half a mile that way. There's a bus stop, that's what I mean to say. It's a bus stop just there. But let's go and have a look, see what we can see. So, Guildford Model Engineering Society exists silhouette of a traction engine. They've got a few different railways. Well, they've got two passenger carrying railways. They've got various model railways of different sizes. So I'm very excited to be spending the afternoon here. We'll be able to have a look at all the different... Oh, thank you very much. So we'll have a look at all the different railways we've got as we come to down here. Oh look, and there's a train passing on the ground level track. So as you can see, you've got the ground level track here and you've got the race track, and over there I can see some various miniature trains. Let's go for a walk down here and then what we'll do, we'll have a look at everything there is to see. Obviously we'll have a ride on both tracks. So the club's been here since 1954. But they've been here since 1958, so quite a long time they've been here with their railways. It has gradually expanded, so I understand. So if you look at the racetrack here, this is the original one, and it used to go over to see where that hedge is. So it was just a circuit round here, and then it was gradually extended right out over there, which we'll have a good look around. And then the ground level track was put in. So it seems everywhere you look, I can just see trains moving about. So my kind of place, really. This is the level crossing gates to get locos in and out of the sheds. There's a Hymex there on a turntable. I can just see a V2. Let's go over here. There's a V2 coming round. Can we get there in time on the ground level track? Green Arrow. That's nice to see Green Arrow. I did have a ride on the full-size Green Arrow just before she was retired. I remember going up to Barrow Hill. She didn't have long left in service, but I really wanted to get Green Arrow for haulage. Oh, look at that, it's a Morris Minor. I know it's not a railway thing, but look, this is cool. Sorry, it's not a Morris Minor, it's always, it's a Morris Traveller. That's really nice. It's a really nice shining example. Now then, let's go and have a look around. So there's various bridges over all the different railways, because the ground level track especially crosses the countryside like a fence. So you kind of can't exactly have a level crossing. So we're going to go over this bridge now. We'll go and buy our tickets and have a ride. Is there a train coming? I think there is. So we'll stand and see a train pass underneath. That's on the ground level track. Pixie, I think it's called. It's not called Pixie, it's called Stoke. It's a Kerr Stewart locomotive. Up on this bridge, we get a fairly good view of the site. So the ground level track goes in a big circuit around here. The racetrack is effectively, you'll see when we go on it. Well, we'll see everything as to where they go. Let's go and have a look at some of the model railways though, seeing as we're coming down here. We've got Gauge 1 set up over here. I've always liked Gauge 1 trains. I used to be a member of the Gauge 1 Association at one point. That's another classic car, look, a Wolsey. And Green Arrow again. I see a train come past on this Gauge 1 model railway. Yeah, there's something coming. What is that? It looks like a fence. No. Yeah, and that's at SNCF, so that's a French railway's locomotive. So that's what I like about coming to these places. Okay, it's all in miniature and models, but you just never know what you're going to see. There's a few locos here, so as you could say, on shed, merchant navy class, an LMS loco, a Q1, standard class 5. Here goes that French loco again. And then over here, so that's gauge 1, there's a 16mm gauge layout, so that's pretty cool. It's a bit like, well, what do you call it, a model village. See various tracks, I can see some steam. So it's all live steam as well. They're all live steam, they're not electric. Look at this, there's an American loco with a very long goods train there. That's a shame. See how it's got vertical cylinders which drive gears, so that's pretty cool. I really like that. So as the Shay locomotive goes off with her rather long goods train, I think it's time I bought my tickets and went for a ride. So if you come to over here, that's the ticket office. That way for the racetrack and that way for the 7 1/4. So I'm going to buy my tickets and let's go and have a ride. just had a ride on the ground level track. There comes the back five. Back five just pulled in behind me. I was on the Kerr Stewart, so coming out over the bridge. That's the racetrack platform below. What I thought I'd do though, before I go for a ride on the racetrack, I thought I'd go and get a cup of tea, and I've been told there's some more interesting stuff to see in the tea room. So the tea room's over where we came in. There's buildings over there. I believe it houses the club's workshop, and then there's tea room, that building there. So if we head over to there, we're going to have a cup of tea. We're told some model railways in there, so we must go and see that. Let's watch this Great Western loco go past us though, now on the racetrack, which we should soon be riding on. Manor class locomotive, Denville Manor, disappearing into the tunnel, which I'm looking forward to riding through later. Let's go over this bridge now. I'm going to have a look at the model railway and the tea room. I could probably stand on this bridge for quite a while watching trains. Perhaps I will later. So we'll go through here now into the tea room, and we'll have a look at the model railways. So let's just watch this loco go past. That's just gone through the station on the fast line, which we saw when we were on the train. Oh, now here is the tea room, so I'll be able to get a cup of tea over there. But look at this, there's a big model railway, big HO gauge model railways, or OO gauge. Told it's a model of Cheltenham St James station, so the railway station's down there. I'll put some footage in of the trains before we go. I'll do a bit of filming. So yeah, it's a Great Western style model railway. See a really nice scene of a Great Western shed just behind me. You can see into the actual engine shed there. Look at that. And then down at this end is the terminus of Cheltenham St James. You quite often see pictures of steam trains with at Cheltenham St James station. You can see the church in the background. You can just see the church there on the wall. So yeah, we'll watch some trains on that. But right now, I'm going to go and have a cup of tea as this train backs into the station.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah.
I've had a great afternoon here at the Guildford Model Engineering Society. I think they're starting to pack up now. There's a Class 66 reversing over there. So it looks like it's the end of the day for most of the locos here. The manor has just gone on shed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my way back to the car and there's a Black 5 with no passengers. So I expect that's going to go on shed again soon. It's a really nice loco. It's got a Jacobite headboard. Been on Jacobite a few times. Great trip. With Black 5 or with any other steam loco. So let's make our way out of over the footbridges and back to where we started. It's been really good fun here this afternoon. It's very easy to get to. I came by car. I think the steam loco is reversing into the shed because that's the main line which we rode on. He's going that way into the shed. Let's go down, we'll see it go past. Yes, you can get here easily. I came by car, but you can get here very easy by public transport. Like I said, by train, there's a bus stop literally just outside. Let's just see this Black 5. Jacobite here. So, yeah, as I said, it really is the end of the day now. So, really enjoyed it here. So, you know, if you're out Guildford Way, do come and visit them. It's a great afternoon to see miniature trains, model trains, steam everywhere, steam of so many different gauges, and it's been pretty good fun. So hope you enjoyed it, the video. Thank you very much for watching, and from the Guildford Model Engineering Society's railway in Guildford, thank you very much for watching and goodbye.